Assalamu alaikum students. Today we are going to discuss graph data structures. As we already discussed in our introduction lectures that there are two types of data structures. One is linear data structures and the other is a non-linear data structures. In linear data structures we have discussed arrays, queues, linked list and stack. What about linear data structures? All the data is accessed sequentially and in a linear way. What about non-linear data structures? We have already discussed tree. Tree is a hierarchical relationship between parent and child. Trees contains edges. Edges is the connection between the nodes or the vertices. Tree follows certain rule related to the connection between the vertices. What is the rule? Rule should be parent-child relationship and the sequence of edges should be connected on that manner. For n nodes, there will be n minus 1 edges in the tree. All the nodes except the root node have exactly one parent. Because this is a parent-child relationship, so you have to follow that rules also. But in case of graph, we have nodes and vertices as well as edges, but graph does not follow any rule related to the connection. Mathematically, we can represent graph as G is equals to V comma E. V is the set of vertices and E is the set of edges. What are vertices? Vertices are the nodes and the edges are the connection between the nodes. As you can see, this is a diagram of graph. What are the set of vertices? A comma B comma C comma D comma E comma F. A, B, E, D, F and C are the number of nodes, or we can say these are the vertices of the graph. And what about edges? A to B, B to E, E to D, D to F, A to C. Edges can be represented with order pairs. These curly brackets represent unordered pair because this is undirected graph. Undirected graph is represented by unordered pair, which represented curly bracket, and directed graph, which have directions, will be represented by order pair. Order pair include round bracket. We have already discussed what are vertices. Common connection point between the edges are called vertices or nodes. We have already discussed edges. Edges are the links or connection between the nodes or the vertices. Directed and undirected graph. What are undirected graph? Graph which have no directions. For example, we can consider social network, Facebook. This is an example of undirected graph. Undirected graph is represented by unordered pair, as we already discussed in our first slide that unordered pair is represented by curly bracket. So, A, B, D, C are the vertices of the graph and what are edges? AB, BD, AD and BC are the edges of undirected graph. Students, as you have noticed that these edges are represented in curly bracket because these are unordered pairs. One thing to note that the order of vertices is not important in undirected graph because it does not include directions. What about directed graph? Directed graph are also called digraph in short. As you can see, this is an example of World Wide Web. All the pages are represented as a nodes or vertices and the connection between the pages are represented as hyperlinks. For example, if we want to go on page Q, then the hyperlink of page Q is on page R. In the same way, this is also an undirected graph. What about this type of connection? Connection on vertex 9. This connection is called self loop. What do you mean by self loop? Vertex directed towards itself is called a self loop. How can we represent this type of graph? Set of vertices are 1, 3, 11, 9, 5 and 7. These are the vertices of the graph. And what about edges? Students, please note the directions of the vertices. 1, 2, 3 and 3, 2, 1. These connections are bidirectional. So, how we represent this? 1 comma 3 and 3 comma 1. First value should be origin and the second value should be destination. In the same way, 11 comma 1, 9 comma 9, because 9 is directed towards itself also. And 9, 11, 5, 9 and 5, 7. This is the representation of directed graph. In directed graph, directions and order of vertices is very important. As you can see, we use circular bracket. This is an order pair of directed graph, round bracket. Weighted and unweighted graph is a very important terminology of graph. What do you mean by unweighted graph? The edges which are unlabeled is called unweighted graph, because as you can see in this diagram, edges are unweighted, there are no values for edges. We consider them one unit. All the edges contain value which is 1, all have equal and constant values. So what is the shortest path between A to D? There are many routes from A to D. For example, one route is A, B, C, D. Second one is A, E and D. Third one is A, E, F and H. Another one is A, E, F and D. So what is the shortest path from city A to city D? A, E, D. Why? Because it contains less number of vertices. Less number of vertices denotes shortest path between the two cities. But what about this case? I have mentioned the distance between city A and B, city B and C and city D. So is the answer is same or change? What is the shortest path now? For your clarity, I have mentioned it in different colorful arrows. For example, one route green arrow, second one yellow, red and black. So what is the shortest path? Now the shortest path is from A, B, C to D. Why it is shortest path? Because we add all the distances and take the total cost. When the total cost is less among all the routes, that one is the shortest path. As you can see, this is also a weighted graph, but weighted and directed graph. This is weighted and directed graph because we have already mentioned colored arrows. Another very important terminology is adjacency. Adjacency is the property of vertices. Vertices connected to each other with the help of edges. For example, when we consider this diagram, we can say A is adjacent to B and B is adjacent to C and C is adjacent to D, or A is adjacent to E, A is adjacent to F, F is adjacent to G. This is undirected graph. What about this? This is directed graph. C is adjacent to C, B is adjacent to C, or we can say that C is adjacent from B. How can we say? Because of arrowhead. Arrowhead represent destination and the start of arrow represent their origin from which the direction start. In the same way, B is adjacent to F, F is adjacent to the last vertice. Okay. Student, also note that this is disconnected graph because this graph is not connected with the vertices. If I connect E with F or D with F, then this will become connected graph. What about D and E adjacency? D is adjacent to E and E is adjacent to D because of bidirection. In the same way, if the graph is directed, so we can say 5 is adjacent to 7 or 7 is adjacent from 5. But what about this? This is undirected. We can say 7 is adjacent from or to 5 because direction is not mentioned. Next very important terminology is path. What is path? Number of edges connected with the vertex can create a path. For example, we can create A, B, C, D is one path. A, E is another path. A, F and G is another path. Consider this diagram and consider the pink mark also. Pink mark is the path. B, E, D and C represent path. In the same way, A, B, E, D and C is another path. A simple path is the path in which the first vertex and the last vertex never repeat. For example, this is a simple path B, E and C, first vertex and last vertex is never repeat. But the opposite of simple path is cycle. What is cycle? In which first vertex and the last vertex is repeat and create a loop or a cycle. For example, consider this example A, C, D and A. First vertex is also A and last vertex is also A. So, this will create a closed path or we can say a cycle. This type of graph is also called cyclic graph and the opposite of cyclic graph is acyclic graph. Another very important terminology is complete graph. What do you mean by complete graph? When all the vertices, each and every vertex is connected with every other vertex. For example, A is connected to B, A is connected to D as well and A is connected to C. In the same way, B is connected to A, B is connected to C and B is connected to D. This is directed complete graph and have bidirections. What about this? This is also a complete graph but this is undirected. What is the length? Simple number of edges. Number of edges represent length of graph. If you want to move from 1 to 4, then you have two paths. Either you go from 1 to 4 or 1, 2, 3 and 4. It's up to you. Two alternate paths are available. Another terminology is the degree of vertex. In case of directed graph, number of incoming edges is called in degree and number of outgoing edges is called out degree. For example, consider this diagram. Vertex A has 1, 2 and 3 outgoing edges and one incoming edge from vertex 4. In the same way, consider vertex 2. Vertex 2 have only one incoming edge from 1 and one outgoing edge to vertex 3. Okay? Consider this diagram as well. 0 has incoming 1 and outgoing 1. 2 has one incoming but no outgoing edge. As you can see that 2 has no outgoing edge. What about undirected graph? How can we calculate the degree of vertex? In undirected graph, degree of vertex is incident on the vertex. What do you mean by incidency? What is adjacency? Adjacency is the connection between the vertices through edges and incidency is the connection of edges between the vertices. So, we can say that adjacency is with respect to vertex and incidency is with respect to edges. See this diagram, you can better understand what is incident edge or what is incidency. If I label these edges with E1, E2, E3 and E4, then E2 is incident on vertex 1 and 3, E3 is incident on vertex 1 and 4, E2 is incident on vertex 2 and 4 and E1 is incident on vertex 1 and 2. Adjacency is the property of edges which connect between the vertices or among the vertices. In the same way, if we consider this graph, this is directed graph. So, how can we say that these graphs are incident? A to D is the direction of this edge. So, A comma D is incident on A from 2 or from terminologies you can fit because of directed graph. Next very important topic is graph searching. We have two types of searches. One is depth first search and another is breadth first search. What about depth first search? In depth first search, you can select one vertex as a start, as a originating vertex or as a source. Then you can select the values or the vertices adjacent to that vertex. One origin vertex and other vertices which are incident from that vertex. Then what can you do? You can examine neighbors of that vertex. Until you can examine all the neighbors of the graph, then your graph search is complete. In case of breadth first search, again first two steps are same. Consider one vertex as a source or origin and consider all the vertices which are what? which are adjacent to that source vertex. Two steps are same. What about third step? We can select one child or pick one child and consider their adjacent childs. Up till we have examined all the childs and no vertices left for visit. So, in depth first search, we use which data structure?
Stack.
We use stack. In breadth first search, we use queue data structures. So, you can better understand with example. We have solved example, then you can better understand the concept between the two searches. First, we have to select one origin. So, we select A. So, mark A, visit A, and push it on stack. What are the adjacent nodes of A? Adjacent nodes of A are B, D, and G. So, according to the alphabetical order, we first visit B. So, visit, mark, and push it on stack. Next adjacent node,
D.
Students, notice what is the last value of a stack?
B.
Last value of a stack is B. So, consider B. What are the vertices adjacent to B? F, A, and E. A is already visited. So, what is left? E and F, according to alphabetical order? E will be visited. So, mark E, visit E, and push it on stack. Then, what is the last value of stack?
E.
Consider the adjacent nodes of E. What are the adjacent nodes? Only G is left because B have been visited. So, mark G, visit G, and push it on stack. Consider G. Adjacent nodes of G are? What are the adjacent nodes of G? A and E. Both have been visited. So, what else we do? Just pop out from stack. What is the last value of E? Both adjacent nodes of E have been visited. So, pop out E also. What are the adjacent nodes of B?
F.
F is left. So, visit and mark F and push it on stack. What are the adjacent nodes of F? C, D. C will be visit first because of alphabetical order. So, mark C, visit C, and push it on stack. Last value is C. H is the adjacent node of C. So, visit and mark H and push it on stack. H has no adjacent node to left. C is also visited. So, pop out from stack. What about C? Pop out. F. D is left. So, mark D, visit D, and push it. Pop out D because all the adjacent nodes have been visited.
F also.
F has adjacent node. B has all visited adjacent nodes. A has all adjacent visited nodes. This is your search and we have completed the search. The next search is breadth first search. Again, select one vertex as a source and consider their adjacent vertices. First two steps are same. So, select A. What are the adjacent nodes of A? B, D, and G. So, again, alphabetical order counts. Visit B, mark B, and enqueue it. Then, another adjacent node. Mark D, visit D, and enqueue it. Another vertex is G. Mark it, visit it, and enqueue it. Any remaining vertices left?
No.
All have done. So, what's next?
DQ.
DQ? B. Correct.
Yes.
And consider B vertices adjacent to B. So, what are the adjacent vertices A has been visited? F and E are left. So, according to alphabetical order, E will be visit first. So, mark it, visit it, and enqueue it. Okay. Any other left? F. Mark it. Visit and enqueue it. Okay. Anyone? All have done. What next?
DQ.
D. Okay. DQ D. Consider their adjacent vertices already visited. So, what else we do? DQG. All the vertices of G has been visited. So, DQE. We have done with E also. So, what left? F is left. So, what are the adjacent nodes of S? C. We have to visit C. So, mark C, NQ it and visit it. Okay. What next?
C.
Mark C and visit C. What are the adjacent nodes of C? Only one is left. G, F is being visited. So, visit H and NQ it. Also consider C adjacent node, so DQ. When we DQ C, F has been visited, H is remaining. So, mark it and visit it and NQ it. Then again DQ H. And consider their adjacent nodes. No one. All have been done. So, our breadth first search is complete. So, last but not the least, the application of graph. What are the applications of graph? Graph has been used in network topology, in intercity node network, in program modules, in board games, in artificial intelligence. So, these are the applications of graph. Any questions regarding lecture? Any confusion? Yes.
Ma'am, tell me about incidency.
Incidency or incident edge.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Incident or incidency is the property of edge with related to vertices. How we can represent edge? Edge is connected to vertices. For example, consider this example. 1 and 3 are two vertices that is connected by E2. E2 is the name of the edge or labeled edge. Why we give E2? Why we labeled this edge? Because we want to show the relationship between 1 and 3 with the help of edge. So, we mark these edges with E1, E2, E3 and E4. Okay. So, how we represent this graph in the form of adjacency? For example, consider this link 1 and 3. 1 and 3 is connected by an edge which is E2. So, how we represent this connection? E2 is incident on vertices 1 and 3. If there is a direction between 1 and 3, for example, 1 is origin and 3 is destination. So, what is the terminology? E2 is incident on vertices 1, 2, 3. Because 1 is origin and 3 is destination. Okay, it depends on directed and undirected graph, or it depends on directed or undirected edges between the vertices. Okay, clear or not?
Clear.
Anyone else?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, as you told us that there are two types of graph, directed and undirected. Directed have direction and undirected don't have direction. So, ma'am, how is it possible that undirected graph don't have directions? Node have must be connected in some direction. So, how
undirected graph doesn't mean that vertices are not connected. Undirected means vertices are connected with each other with undirected edge and with no directions. For example, consider this example which I have given to you. This is directed graph, directions have been mentioned. And what about this graph? A is connected to B. What is the direction? If I given A as a source and B as a destination, so how we translate this type of terminology? A to B, A is an incident to B. If the directions is not mentioned that A is incident to B or B is incident from A or A is incident from B or B is incident to A, both possibilities can happen. both the vertices are connected, but both the possibilities have been happened because no edges is clear, no direction is clear. Vertices are connected, but edges are not clear. So we can concentrate on both terminologies, to and from.
That's
both are connect, correct.
That means both nodes are connected. For example, take A and B.
Consider bi-directional nodes. Both the nodes are connected. A to B or B to A, it's same. Okay. Anyone else?
It is possible that one edge have more than two vertices.
Yes. One edge is connected. More than one is edge is connected to vertice. 9 has 3 edges. One edge is directed towards itself. One edge from 5 and one edge to 11. Understand terminology to and from? From origin to destination. Okay, it's clear?
Yes.
Any confusion?
No, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.